Hello YouTube, it's Minecraft Grand, the Geeky Minecrafter, coming at you with another video in the Let's Play series. I believe we're on episode 54, or perhaps it's 55, I don't know, you'll see it in the description. And today I'm working on a multi-item sort and storage system with Lyarra, who is new to the Archimon server. Say good morning, Lyarra.
Good morning.
Is it morning where you are?
No, it's early evening.
Okay, it's early evening where I am too. It just feels like morning for me. It is Sunday. We're having fun playing Minecraft. And I have to tell you, I'm a geek, but even geeks have problems. We began recording this when I just had the system laid out on the floor. Nothing else was built. The ceiling was too lower. And so we recorded, I want to say, 40 minutes of video of us building this out and raising the ceiling and putting in this down here. Only to discover that Minecraft was in full screen mode, which, as any of you who record videos know, doesn't record Minecraft. So you saw the opening scene and nothing changed. So that 40 minutes of effort is gone. Sorry, you'll never see that again. But we've decided to just continue. I'm not going to pull it down or re-record it. We're just going to continue from where we're at. Now, Lyarra is helping me with this. She's put all the chests in and finish building this up. I'm working on the mechanics right down here. So I'm going to pause the video, or actually I'm going to get her on her next task, and then I'm going to show you the bit underneath. So Lyarra, right up here, actually here's the video, here's the hoppers. I have a couple of sets right there.
Got it.
So if you'll take those hoppers and on the back of each chest, point it into the chest. So there'll be one on each chest all the way around.
Okay.
And I will continue right over here. So this is a TangoTek design. He says to put your input chest here. Well, if you'll remember, I'm going to take you upstairs. If you'll remember, I have an input chest upstairs too. I have this fish farm right here that is turning out a lot of stuff. Puffer fish and raw fish. I mean, just more than I can count. So I put a sorter input right here. The theory being, if I drop something in here, it will flow down into the system. So when I built this little bit right here, I extended that down and added hoppers all the way in. So I have two methods. Now there'll be hoppers underneath this that flow into the system, but that comes from upstairs as well. So you don't have to come down here and use it. Now, as I mentioned in the earlier video that you missed, I will be opening up this sorting system to the general public. This is my portal that comes in. As you can see, when you get out, you'll be able to see the sorter. Now, this is a very open and advanced community. They're very giving. Tell me a little bit about your experience, Lyarra. I know you did earlier.
I was amazed. I've never been on a whitelisted server before, and I was a little hesitant to put in an application, because I thought maybe you had to be a super Minecraft player. And I put in my application yesterday, and I heard back in a few hours that I was accepted. And I logged on the server and was greeted by another player. And you showed up a little time after that. And everybody made me feel so welcome, and I was given tours of the different bases and encouraged to ask questions, and it was just such a wonderful, warm welcome and a great feeling of community. It's the kind of server I've been looking for ever since I've played Minecraft.
Oh, I agree. That's one of the reasons I've stayed so long on this server. Now, I play on a couple of different servers, but Archimonde is one I just keep coming back to. The community here is just amazing. Give me just a minute, I'll be right back.
What do you mean by three? It's going to be...
three droppers.
Oh, no, it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 droppers. Stacked.
You're talking about the top.
Yes,
one.
Yes.
Oh, I thought you meant the
bottom
one.
No, so this
one.
This is like an item elevator. So we're going to... it's going to come into the input chest, and we're going to do a bunch of mechanics. And then it's going to force it all the way to the top hopper.
Got
and
it.
Then there's actually going to be two more droppers turned in, but this is a, you know, Henry Ford, because we like our assembly lines. This is what we need next, is these droppers stacked one atop the other. And if you run out, let me know. I can make some more. I have all the materials I need for that.
Okay. I'm going to dump what I've got in my inventory that I'm not using. Yeah.
And then I'm going to
throw... Turn.
Yeah, I understand. Okay, so... Lyarra is going to take care of the assembly line for this. We've got droppers that head all the way up to the top. The two droppers on the top face in towards the chest. She's placed a temporary block in front of the chest. Tell me you took it out, right?
Yes, okay, I did. And it's on the other side. I'm going to pick it up now, and then I'll come back.
So she placed a temporary block and then pointed the last two hoppers up into that. And what that's going to get us is, let me point here. Let me get this out of the way. So what that's going to get us is, from the mechanics down below, which I've not put in yet, the items will flow up to the very top. They'll go into this one, and they'll flow down. And any that meets the item that's inside the chest will flow into the chest. It'll flow out, across, back into this dropper chain. It'll go up, and then back down here. So what we're going to have is one long, continuous, serpentine flow of items, and they'll be pulled out and placed in the chest if they match the item that's already in that slot. Now, one thing that needs to happen in this system versus the others, when you have items in a chest, you'll need to fill up every single slot. Now, you'll be able to fill it up like this. You can have this many be dirt, and this many be droppers. I mean, I'm just making this stuff up here, okay? But with one each in every slot, then if it matches, it'll flow in here. If it doesn't match, it won't. So in this way, you'll be able to have all your redstone items in one chest. And for example, if you want to do, 15 slots for pistons, 4 slots for torches, and the rest for redstone, you can. That's what I love about this system. Have you ever seen the video for this, Lyarra?
I have seen several sorter videos, but I don't know if this is the same.
Oh, I think you're going to be impressed with this. Now, it's resource intensive, but I think it's going to be so worth it.
I'm looking forward to building one on my own claim, so I think it'll be interesting.
Sorry.
Did you just place those blocks?
I did. I was giving you that first block. I was trying to see if we had enough below it, and I don't think we do. I didn't realize that all the way around it was going to have to be dug out, but...
Right.
I guess for the placement, at least initially, it will.
I was just checking to make sure you were paying attention.
Oh, no, I was watching a video. You got me. Okay. He makes it look so easy in the video, right?
Well, he's done it 3 million times.
Well, and he has creative mode, too. That really helps. So
yes.
This hopper points into that temporary block. That's right. There we go. Try this. Will you let me do this? Yes. Okay, so that hopper there points into that dropper. So the last row comes down and flows into this dropper. This dropper makes it turn a corner, and we will flow it back this direction. Okay, so now wire up the input chest. That is, it's coming out of the bottom of this and gonna wire up over here. So I need a hopper pointing in. Let's see, let's jump up. I want a hopper pointing into this dropper. And then we want a hopper coming from under this chest into that hopper. So like that. So that'll drain that chest into that hopper. It'll flow into this dropper line. So now that's wired in. Or the item flow is in, I should say. Okay, let's put my lever on. Do I have the lever with me? I do. How convenient. Okay, lever goes here. This is going to be the item lock. So this system can be a little noisy when it's running. So the purpose of the item lock is to let you, lock things down, load up this chest with whatever you want, and then when you're ready to walk away and let it sort, you flip this switch, it unlocks it, and things flow. Now, I do need a block below. Let's see. Let's put a couple of temporary blocks there. And there, that's right below. And then one here. I don't need this one or this one. But I do need redstone right there, which I do not have. Let's grab that. All right. Okay, so if I understand this correctly, turning this switch off fires that redstone, which fires this block, which locks that hopper right there. So let's test that, okay? Let's put some dirt in here. The dirt's going nowhere. I've turned this off. The dirt is being drained. So that's all working. Beautiful. Now it's hitting that system. It's not, you know, it's not doing everything yet because I don't have it wired in. That's the next little bit here. So this is a little more complicated than I realized. I'm watching the video while I'm doing this, so I believe that's where that goes. It's going to get, oh, I just knocked a hole out here. It's going to get a comparator that goes there. I need some scaffolding. See, it's so helpful that he's building this, but he's building it in creative. So he just jumps all over the dang place.
Fly is so nice.
Fly is nice. Fly rocks. So my comparator goes right here, and I just went over and made some. So let's put that right there. Oh, I can't jump, really? Let's try that. Okay, pointing out, that's good. Then it goes into a solid block. Now I know it.
I would enjoy doing this even if you hadn't been so welcoming and done the welcome.
Yeah.
I enjoy helping.
That's where I'm at, and I normally go and help other people with their projects, but this is one of those projects that has just been. Oh, it's just been on my head. I need this. My Virgo little head needs this. I've got to be organized.
I can't believe you live so close, relatively speaking, internet-wise, yeah. And that you're a Virgo, too.
Yep, see, great minds, right? We're both attracted to the same kind of thing, I think.
It's because we do it right. The rest of the world is just... not up to our
standards. Right? That's what I'm saying. Okay, so we get there. Where's my torches? They go there.
Didn't you say that I get to keep all the diamonds?
Absolutely.
I find? Well,
absolutely.
We're at what, level 75 or something? 53. Well, you know.
53 what?
We're at level 50. I'm at level 53
right
now.
Yeah, I'm at zero. Remember? I just died. So, for those of you on YouTube who missed it, because we did record it, but it didn't catch. So, right up there is my fish farm. And if you'll remember from an earlier video, I have a disposal system, an automatic disposal system. And there was lava in there. So, as... she came through and was knocking down this part of the ceiling, that lava began flowing. Well, I'm concerned, right? I see her running around with no armor. So I jump. I see I've lost my sound in the game again. Okay, YouTube. We're just not supposed to make this video. That's the bottom line. We've had 40 minutes of lost footage, audio problems out the wazoo. You know what a wazoo is, right?
Yeah.
Okay, good. We've had a lot of problems, and I do not have a standard piston. Are you kidding me?
We have an issue. Houston, there is a problem.
Houston, there is a problem. I'm on my way back down. You can show me the problem.
Okay.
Here I come. Okay.
In the corner,
uh-huh.
An item frame is not going to go beside an item frame. Oh! They fixed it. It does.
Okay. I was going to say, I just watched the video and they did this. So
I'm sure I tried to do that when I was building a bunch of chests in 1.8.
Oh, I'm sure that's true. Yeah.
If you had an item frame on one block, the one facing it, there was no way. the one adjacent, it was, it took up the entire block.
Yeah, it was considered a full block. And right. That's one of the reasons, by the way, that item frames jack up your entity count. Because
I wondered about that.
Yeah, they do, because they're no longer like solid blocks, but they are counted as entities. So, yeah. So you get it in the corner, but you count it as an entity. Hey, Naz. Okay, I'm going to pause the video for a second, see if I can get him in here. Okay, quick intro again. This is, I don't know, the seventh or eighth time. We have had so many problems, and this is going to be a cut-together mish-mash. But I'm going to try and record some more. Apparently, my audio just randomly decides to quit, and then we wind up having to restart everything again. So just to recap where we're at, we are building TangoTek's multi-item sorting system. We're stuck right here, but while we were here, JDNAZ just did a run-through. Oh, I see him coming through again. There you go, bud. And we can leave these doors open. So I see you better prepared. You see me running around here with no armor on, right?
Yeah, what's that all about?
There's a story. So you remember my disposal system upstairs?
Right.
So we're raising the ceiling by two. And Lyarra, I have it wrong again, don't I?
It's Lyarra, but it's fine.
Lyarra. Okay. So Lyarra is helping me raise the ceiling, and she hits it, and the lava starts flowing, and she says, oh, my God, there's lava. It's raining
nice.
Down. Right. So I forget that I don't have my fireproof armor on, and I run up to help. I'm going to save her, right?
Okay.
And I slipped off the block and fell into the lava and died.
Wow.
Lost, I don't know, 65 levels.
All you got is your diamond booties on.
Yep. Yeah, so now I do. She did manage to save the rest. I've got it up here. I've got my booties on because, you know, we're working pretty high and I didn't want to take the damage, the full damage. But yeah, it's crazy.
Nice sorter room.
Yeah, it's going to be. What do you think? Think I'm going to have enough items?
I think you're all right. Yeah.
Lyarra, he's a Virgo too.
This is a lot like the first one I did. I like him better like this because you get more items.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yep.
So, Lyarra, did
you
hear me?
You doing the redstone?
I can hear you.
The input? Where's
your
input at right here?
We're working on that right now. Yeah. So, Lyarra, he's a Virgo too.
You're kidding.
No, I'm not.
For real.
Never run into any Virgo.
For real, right? So, yeah, I grabbed my input line from upstairs and I married it to this chest. So, no matter how they come in, if they want to, you know, if they want to come up and open it here, they can input from here or they can input from the chest upstairs.
Gotcha. Yeah.
So I'm just about to build the timer clock and all that goes underneath. And then we're replicating the buildings or the modules. So one of you has a sound in the background. It sounds like somebody's spray can painting something.
Are you one of you
a taggers?
No.
I hear it through my headset too, but it's not me.
Okay.
I don't hear it, but I'm not doing anything.
Okay. Well, it could be a compressor, air compressor, AC unit in the background. I know mine. You probably hear mine.
My
I just wondered.
Is on, but I don't hear it. I mean, I don't hear it. It's not loud.
Okay. So what we've been doing, Naz, and you're welcome to stay and help, or you're welcome to go continue doing whatever you're doing. But I just wanted you to see what we've done. We've gotten pretty far today, haven't we?
Yes, we have.
Well, you've done all this today. You've been busy.
Well, I laid out the template on the floor. Just, you know, this block, this chest, this block. I laid that out. Mm-hmm. It took me 3 times to get it where it would line up right. So I wound
up
taking...
See, I hear that now. It sounds like somebody's painting. I hear that.
I know. Spray can, right?
It does.
I hear it. And
that's crazy.
I'm not painting anything.
Oh, right. I believe you. It's probably just some bleed overflow coming through TeamSpeak. Who knows? It comes and goes. So, YouTube, I apologize. I'll try to...
Oh.
Did you fall in the hole?
I did. I was trying to...
Yep.
This is a combination
Where's your
Ken Parker,
you get it up
of course.
To sort it? Are you sending it up in dispensers or what? Where do you get? How you get
right
it up
there, droppers. Yeah. So in this design, Jim, I'm sorry, Naz, come over here. I'll show you. So the input chest feeds down to this hopper. All right, come down here with me, bud.
Right.
So this hopper right here that I'm standing directly under, this one feeds it to here, which feeds it into the dropper. The dropper sends it up to the top. The top dropper is pointed into the hopper on top, which is not connected to a chest. So that starts the flow down.
Gotcha.
It comes all the way down, and then when it reaches the bottom, it goes into this hopper, turns, and goes into this dropper, and then goes all the way back up, and then flows back down. And if you can see from right here, this hopper I'm standing right underneath is pointed into this next dropper, which picks it up and moves it along. Then three hoppers into this next one, and this begins the next module. So where I'm standing right now ends one module. I'm actually standing at the in-between.
I see, okay.
So they're tileable. So if we come look at the front here, okay, so a module is this line with the diorite, the two chests, and then the line with the diorite. So that's one module. And you have a blank in between it, which I've just used sideways facing furnaces. And then is the next module. So they're tileable. I can literally stop it at 1 or 50 or 100. They just chain together one module at a time. I know. I'm pretty stoked. And if we can ever get it finished, I don't know if we're going to be able to do it all in one video. And we may, I may do with this what I've done on some of the others and just, you know, stop the video, go finish it up, and then do a tour.
Right.
Because, God, it's painful to record it with audio problems. But it's coming along. I think if I could stop bouncing back and forth between the various apps and watching the video, and
this is all the redstone you got to use because it's redstone.
No,
it's
I'm not
natural,
quite done.
Right?
No, oh, I'm okay. not quite done. Yeah, it's but all of the redstone for all of the modules will be under this one section.
Oh, okay.
Because everything starts at the input and flows around. Now there's redstone on the back of each of these. There's, you know, there's going to be like half slabs right here, and on top of this is going to be a. What you call it?
Separator?
A repeater. And then there'll be another one here, and then this will be a full-size block here behind this, and then there'll be redstone torches pointed over. I mean, it's really pretty compact when it's all said and done, but I have to get this bit done next. This is where I'm working. And this piston hasn't fired, and it's supposed to, and I'm trying to figure out why it hasn't. See, it jumped up, and it went really fast, and I lost my block. So I'm missing a repeater or something. I don't know. This one on two ticks into a full block, and then redstone, I think is how it went. So, yeah, I'm pausing, going to look, looking at the next one. Yep. So that's where we're at. So I'm going to pause the video and go finish this little redstone clock, and I'll walk you through it when I get it done. Haven't been to sleep since you joined the server. That's pretty funny. Okay, well, if you want to finish, let's do a wrap-up for YouTube, and I'll just do a tour video after this. So,
okay.
Just to let you know where we were at YouTube, we were paused, we were talking. Lyarra has reached the limit of her endurance. She joined the server yesterday and has been playing pretty much nonstop since. And it's her head is about to fall into her chalky poo pudding. So we're going to say goodbye to Lyarra, and we're going to probably, I don't know, we might record a little bit more. We may wrap this up and then give you a tour of this after. So I thank you for your help, Lyarra. You've been an amazing help.
It has been a delight. I'm just so glad to have found the server, and I will see you tomorrow.
I'm sure. You're welcome.
Bye.
Good night. Okay, so Naz, it's you and me, and okay, well, as it turns out, JDNAZ left and Lyarra left, so I am on my own. I'm pretty close to having this first module ready to test. I think what I'll do is wrap that up. I'll finish that up with you online, and then I'll go offline and wire all of these others up. Once you do the first one, it's kind of repetitive, and I know I've stopped the video a number of times. I know you've missed a lot of this. So ideally, once I get this first one wired in, it's really just going to be this connection and the wiring, this connection and the wiring. Now, there's a little bit of extra stuff you have to do right here to turn this corner, but I think it's just a couple of extra hoppers and maybe a couple of extra redstones and a repeater. The rest of this is all going to be somewhat the same. Now, there are two parts to this clock right down here. This one contains enough blocks, 1.5 blocks. So it's basically one stack for every 3 modules. And I have 8 modules. So that's 3, 6, and I've got 2 more, so I figure a half. Maybe a bit more than a half, but it's a timing issue. I'll be able to figure that out once I have it all put together. I'm not going to worry about it for right now. So basically, this moves back and forth and holds the whole system on for it to reach all the way around. And then this clock is the one that actually powers everything. So with everything flowing over here, it goes back and forth, but again, that just holds it open. This is the clock that pulses when you have items in the input chest. And I think I can throw a little bit in. Let's see, right now it's locked. Okay. And you here, there you go. See it pulsing, going back and forth and pulsing. So it'll continue to do that until that other hopper set over there stops or it reaches the end, whichever comes first. And I'm not sure about that last statement. It might just keep staying open until that ends, and then it'll turn off. Now, it's all about timing, and Tango says, you know, it's trial and error. So I'm going to turn that off, let it finish firing, and again, we're just waiting on that hopper bit down there to finish. So that's it. I think we're now ready to wire up the back bits, and that's this right here. And if I understand it correctly, it goes not this one, but this one will do here and here, right? And then here and here. Actually, no, I think I placed these wrong. I think these go on the top of the one above. So like that. Yep, that's right. So this will repeat. And then these two blocks in the center, I believe, are full blocks. Right there and right there. And then, and this is where it's going to get interesting. I'm going to need some extra scaffolding up here, I think. So just like on the one down below, we're going to have a repeater there and a repeater there with redstone across the back. But now I need to get over there. And I need to put 2 torches on the inside, right there and right there. Now, see, that wasn't so bad. So I just have to do this all the way up. So I think what I'll do is I'll put my scaffolding right here. I think I can reach everything from here, right? Oh, gosh, I hope I have everything I need in my inventory. So there and there, there and there. Full block here and here. Repeater here and here. And then torches. Oops. Where did that go? That went somewhere that I wasn't expecting it to go. Yeah, right there. Oh, you cannot knock a block down with fish. It's just not possible. Well, okay, it's probably possible, but you'll be here a while. Okay, so careful placement right there. Okay, next little bit. So I'll probably, once this first one is done, I'll probably just, you know, turn the music on, we'll jam a little bit, and I'll speed build through this. Repeater, repeater. So I don't know about you guys, but I find that having people like Naz and Lyarra to play with just makes this oh so much more fun. They are good people, and they care about the game, and, you know, there's nothing better than that, really. Oh, I'm not going to be able to get on top of there, am I? Does it go all the way up like this? I suppose I ought to take a look. Actually, I think that one doesn't need to be there. That one doesn't need to be there. That one doesn't need to be there. But I do need, believe it or not, torches on the inside. Right. Come on, let me in. Right here and here. Now, he does say in his video that this is where we're going to wire stuff up. So I'm assuming redstone across here. And then this is going to take it to the next module, I believe. So let's pull my scaffolding down. I'm going to regret it, but I think that's everything wired and done. Let's take a look at this. Does this look like his? It does. It does. And that does. Okay. Oh, look at this. I can feel it. We're getting really close. Well, that did it. Okay, so I wired this last little bit in. It's these four blocks right here that I just added. So this one on top of the torch, half slab, and then redstone on top of the hoppers. And now I actually hear it firing. I actually believe it's now moving things around the way they're supposed to be. So now I get why he said you may want to put this lever right here. Let's see. Let's move this over a little bit. Just to shut it down, stop making noise while you're running around for a bit. So let me do that. And this is, you know, you just take it off when you're done. You know, turn it back on when you're done, and then the whole thing should flow. So I just don't want it making noise while I'm building, because that would just kind of drive me crazy. Okay, so I've got that wired all up. This is what ties the rest of the system together, so what causes it to push everything back up and start it back down and around and over. So, you know what? We've been doing this a while, and I apologize for how many difficulties we've had, how many stops and starts, and how disjointed it may seem. That's not my normal method for Let's Plays, and I do apologize. I do try to be better prepared. So I think I'm going to call it right here. Until next time, guys, happy mining. Okay, I changed my mind, so psych. So here's what I think I want to do. Basically, the system, I think, the first module is done. And what I think what I'd like to do is test it. I'm pretty sure it'll work. I did just find one piece of missing redstone right up there. I do have quite a bit in there. Actually, probably way more than I need for this test. I don't need it to stay on that long. Let's see, I have... You know, I'm going to leave it. It's okay. I'll shut it off before the ticking bothers you. So basically what I need to do, just to further explain the way this works, I'm going to jump up here and I'm going to fill up the first few chests. And I'm going to make sure that stone is something that I'm going to have a lot of. So in the event I don't choose what goes in this chest, I want it to be stone. That's pretty fair. You know, again, I got a lot of stone. So we'll fill all these in, and then we'll figure out what we want to test with. And again, remember this is multi-item, so I can do anything in any of these that I want. I just have to pick what goes where. Oops, come here. I should do this in groups of 64. Okay, I'm not going to come all the way down. I don't need to, because what I'll do is I'll put the test in the first couple of chests. Okay, so it's going to hit this chest first, but I want to skip it. I want to try this. So I'm going to say, okay, put torches there. Okay? And maybe not this one, but this one. Let's do redstone there, and I just need the one. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to put torches and redstone in the inputs down here. It's going to skip this first chest because it doesn't match any of this. It's going to check to see if any of this matches. It does. It's going to be the torch, so it's going to drop. The theory here is it's going to drop the torches there, and it's going to find this one and put the redstone there. So I think, let's see, let's lock it. Let's see what I have. There's 21 of those. Is that all the torches I have, really? Well, okay. I guess so. God knows I've used enough in this room. So, 6 torches and 21 redstone. The chest is locked. Let me go make sure this item lock is off. Okay. And that's just because I was tired of listening to the clicking noise. Okay, you ready? Everything's in here. Here we go. Now, it is a bit noisy. You can hear that, obviously. It is going to be ticking until it finishes. The clocks are firing. All of this is firing. So, if this is working, I have... nothing in this one. 5 torches here. Nothing in this one. And look at this. So it's working. I don't remember how much redstone I put in there, but apparently quite a bit. So it works. The first module works. Now all I have to do is tie them together and keep it going on around. So pardon my restarting the video at the end here. And you know, maybe I'll put the farewell message here. Oh my goodness, back up. Oh, there we go. Okay. So till next time, this is Minecraft Grand signing out. Happy mining.